Hello students, welcome back to this course on digital forensics. So far we have seen a lot of different tools and technologies using which we can actually capture evidences, analyze those evidences, validate those evidences using hashing, and a lot many things we have covered so far. Now let me discuss about the remaining topics of this course. These are few of the topics that we are going to cover in the upcoming few videos. First, we are going to understand what is the structure of a PDF file and how to analyze a particular PDF file, whether it consists of some malicious payloads or not. So we are going to make use of tools such as PDF ID and PDF parser in Kali Linux and analyze a particular PDF file, whether it is malicious or not. Followed by another video on image files. Now it is very important to analyze certain image files also from a digital forensics point of view. How is it that much important? Well, for example, you have captured some images or extracted certain images from a hard disk. Now, I'm not talking about the disk images that we had captured during the disk acquisition phase. I am talking about the regular images of JPG, BMP, PNG, etc., etc. formats. So, how can we capture evidences from those images? Well, as we all know, each and every image consists of some metadata. Now, what exactly is a metadata? We are going to learn about that in this particular video and how we can capture evidences from those metadata information using a tool called Imago. Next up, we are going to learn about password cracking. Now, why is password cracking important from digital forensics point of view? Well, it is very important because if you have captured a computer or if you have seized a computer from a crime scene, and if it is password protected, then how will you analyze those evidences? How will you capture those evidences from that computer? Well, in that case, you have to actively breach into that computer's security using brute force techniques, dictionary based techniques, word list based techniques, and then you will be able to crack those passwords. Now we are going to learn how passwords can be cracked using word list based techniques, dictionary based techniques, brute force based techniques using different tools in successive videos. In the third topic, we are going to learn about John the Ripper, and the theory behind these topics will be covered from this beautifully written book on digital forensics by Dr. Jitendra Pandey and Dr. Ajay Prasad. From this book, we are going to learn the basic aspects of what exactly is password cracking, what are the various types of password cracking, what is a brute force attack, what is a dictionary based attack, what is a rainbow table attack. We are going to learn all about those in detail from this chapter 2.6, section 2.6, that is application password crackers. From this section 2.6, that is application password crackers. So we are going to learn about what is brute force attack, what is dictionary attack, what is rainbow attacks, and then we are going to perform the practicals on these theory topics, followed by a section completely dedicated to web attacks and information gathering. Now we all know that web applications are very much prone to attacks by the attackers. It can be a passive attack or it can be even an active attack. We are going to learn how the information can be captured or gathered from a website and how those informations can be actually used to launch an attack on the victim. We are going to learn what is Whois lookup, what is NS lookup, what is the use of the tool Netcraft. Then we will learn about few attacks theoretically as well as from a practical point of view. We are going to learn what is denial of service attack. We are also going to learn what is SQL injection, what is website spoofing, that is nothing but phishing only. So we are going to learn all of these from this particular section, types of web attacks. And we are not only going to learn about the theory, but we are also going to learn about how practically these attacks are performed and what are the various information that we can capture from these particular web attacks. So without wasting much time, let's get started with our very first topic, that is analysis of PDF files in Kali Linux. So what is the objective behind analyzing PDF files with the use of these tools such as PDF ID and PDF parser? Well, PDF files, as you can see, this is also one of the PDF files. PDF files are nothing but the files stored in the PDF format, which consists of text, images, multimedia objects, etc., etc. It is basically a portable digital format which you can send across multiple domains. You can send it on WhatsApp, you can send it on emails, and the content inside it doesn't change. Whereas as compared to doc files or Word files, the contents might change, the formatting might change, which doesn't happen with PDF. That is why PDF comes really handy when you want to share some document with a friend of yours on the internet, because it protects the data from any modifications, or it protects the data from any accidental formatting changes. That is one of the advantages of PDFs. Now what happens is, this simple looking PDF could actually consist of some malicious data as well. That is what we call as payloads. So malicious payload in the form of some JavaScripts, some clickable actions which are actually hidden. For example, over here we can't see anything on the page, but just imagine there is some invisible link over here, and if you click on it, you may get redirected to a malicious website. So that is why it is very important to check the contents of a PDF file before actually loading it up, before actually reading it. So for that purpose, we are going to make use of two tools, PDF ID and PDF Parser. Let me first discuss about what exactly PDF ID is all about. Now, PDF ID is a by default tool that comes with Kali Linux pre-installed. PDF ID is a tool which is basically used to go through the contents of a PDF document and tell you whether that particular PDF document consists of some malicious scripts or not. It is not going to parse the entire PDF document. It is not going to render the PDF document. It is simply going to tell you whether that PDF document is consisting of any malicious payload, any JavaScript, any clickable actions, etc., etc. It will not give you a detailed analysis of what that particular PDF file consists of. It will simply break that PDF file into its header structures, into its tree structures, and it will tell you whether it consists of any malicious data or not. So its usage is very simple. It comes inbuilt with Kali. What you can do is, you can simply go to your terminal and enter this value, PDF dash minus H, and then it will give you all the options available in the help command. For example, it will scan the given directory, it can display all the names, it can display extra data like dates, it can force the scan of the file even without a proper PDF header, etc., etc. Now let us discuss about the usage of this PDF ID tool. The example shown over here is working on a PDF document called as lminfo.pdf, and as you can see, the keyword is very simple. You have to type PDF ID space the path of that entire PDF document and press enter, and this is what the output looks like. It starts with the PDF header. PDF header is nothing but the header of that PDF document. This is where the actual investigation will begin from. PDF ID, this is nothing but the PDF 1.4, this is nothing but the version of the PDF document. It is of version 1.4. It might vary in your case. And these are the values shown over here, which are of importance to us. Using these, we will come to know whether our PDF document is malicious or not. There is a very beautiful repository on GitHub. You can simply go to Google and search for this keyword, that is PDF ID GitHub. And the second one is nothing but a detailed GitHub repository where you will come to know the documentation about each and every command. For example, over here, let me show you what is an object, what is an end object, what is a stream, what is end stream, what is xref trailer, and star txref. So just have a look over here. The output looks like this. It consists of number of object, it consists of number of streams, end streams, trailer, etc. Here is where our investigation should be more focused on. That is, how many number of pages are present in that particular document. So page gives an indication of the number of pages in the PDF document. Slash encrypt indicates that the PDF document has digital rights management or it has a password. For example, whether it is password protected or not, you will come to know using this particular field. So let me check this example. Hash encrypt is 0, so this particular PDF file is not password protected. Then comes object stream. It counts the number of object streams. An object stream is basically a stream object that can contain other objects. So for example, if the object stream is 1, so it might link your PDF document to some other objects inside that PDF document. So it is basically used to hide something inside a document so that its actual intention is not revealed upfront. Clear? Next up, we are having JavaScript JS. This is also very crucial to look into. If your PDF document is having some JavaScript or JS files embedded, then it might have some malicious content inside it. It is not always the case that if a particular PDF document is consisting of JavaScripts, it is malicious. It's not like that. It might be malicious if it consists of JavaScripts. Similarly, we have other things over here, AA, open action, and then the combination of the automatic action AA and JavaScripts makes a PDF document very suspicious. So if you are having something over here in the AA field and the JavaScript field and the JS field, then it might lead to suspicions, and we may think that this particular PDF document might have something malicious hidden inside it. Same goes with open action. Open action is nothing but some clickable objects which should not be present inside a PDF document, or it might lead you to some malicious website. Similar thing goes with rich media, JBIC to decode. JBIC to decode is nothing but it indicates whether a compressed JPEG file or any particular image file is present inside your malicious, inside your PDF document or not. So if some document has gone through compression and stored inside your PDF document, you will come to know using this JBIC to decode keyword. Same goes with rich media. It may consist of flash. So right now flash is obsolete, but if your PDF document consists of flash documents, it might have some malicious content inside it. So going through all these keywords, you will come to know whether your particular file is malicious or not. Right now, we don't have any malicious PDF documents with us to test this tool. So let us download a malicious PDF document from this developer's website itself. So we don't end up corrupting our computer system by downloading any actual real malicious file. So for that, what you can do is you can simply visit this website. For that, go to Google and type this malicious PDF sample download. And you can scroll down to a website like this, blog.ddrstevens.com. This is nothing but the website of that developer. This particular tool has been designed by Didier Stevens, PDF ID as well as PDF Parser. Both of these tools are designed by this particular developer itself. So you can scroll down and you can download this particular malicious PDF document. Save it on your virtual machine. Just for safe side, run this inside your virtual machine only. Don't run this inside your host machine, because your anti-malware softwares will automatically detect it as a threat and delete that. So for safety reasons and for performing this experiment, run this inside your virtual machine. So go to that location. I guess this is the file. Open the file, extract it, and for that you would need some sort of a password, and that password is mentioned over here in the website itself. It is EICAR dropper, where EICAR is in caps. So you can simply go over there and type EICAR and DROPPER. You will be able to download this particular file. You will be able to download that file. After the download is complete, simply go to that location. I guess it should be present in downloads folder. So go to downloads, and this is that particular file. I won't open it right now. What I will do is I will rename this file to something as malicious and move it or copy it on the desktop. As you can see, I already have one more PDF on my desktop called safe. So this particular PDF is not having any malicious content. I can open this for you, and this is nothing but my notes on Buffer Overflow. So this is a non-malicious or safe document, but I won't be running this malicious PDF. What I will do is, the very next task is I will be examining this malicious PDF document using our tool called PDF ID. So for that, you can simply go to terminal and type in PDF ID, or you can do one more thing. You can go to this applications, go to forensics, PDF forensic tools, and inside that, the first tool is PDF ID. Open that, and now what you need to do is you simply need to follow the usage pattern. That is PDF ID followed by the file name. So enter PDF ID followed by the file name. Now let me run this on the safe PDF first. So let me copy this path. It is present on home folder, desktop. So let me copy this slash safe dot pdf. So if I run this, it should obviously give me the number of pages and all those keywords we saw earlier. So as a result, you can see that it consists of 142 objects, and the main thing begins from here. It consists of 3 pages. You can verify that if you want to open it, and you will see it consists of 3 pages, right? It doesn't consist anything else. So we can say that this particular PDF document is safe. On the other hand, now if I want to investigate the malicious PDF, I would simply need to change the name of that PDF document and press enter. And as a result, you can see that it consists of only a single page. In most of the cases where a malicious document is shared, it will generally consist of a single page only. It consists of nothing which is encrypted. We saw that the PDF document was not encrypted, but the zip file was encrypted, right? So the PDF document is not encrypted, and the thing which we are concerned about is the presence of JavaScripts. As you can see, it consists of JavaScripts. You can also see it consists of some open action links. It also consists of an embedded file. So this is something suspicious, right? So we need to be very cautious whenever we are dealing with such a PDF document. So this is all about PDF ID. So this particular tool is used to notify you, alert you before actually opening the PDF document that this particular PDF document might consist of some suspicious or malicious files or embedded files present inside it. So for the time being, let me open this PDF document as we are running this inside a virtual machine. So we are not bothered about damaging our machine. So as I have opened this particular PDF document, you can see that this PDF file contains a doc file with VBA EICAR dropper. Nothing else is mentioned over here. So you cannot see any JavaScript, you cannot see any embedded document, you cannot see any open links over here. But trust me, this particular document consists of a document file also. And that is what we are going to analyze in our next tool, that is PDF parser. Because PDF ID just tells you that this particular file, PDF document, might be malicious or might be suspicious. The next tool, PDF parser, is used to parse each and every lines of that PDF document, and it will tell you in detail what actually is contained inside that PDF document. So stay tuned for the next tool, that is PDF parser. So let's first understand what PDF parser is. For that, let me go to the documentation of PDF parser. You can simply type PDF parser Kali, and this is the particular tool we are talking about. So PDF parser, as its name suggests, it is going to parse through the entire PDF document to identify the fundamental elements which are basically used in that particular file which we are analyzing. So we are not only talking about whether it consists of JavaScript, whether it consists of embedded files or not. We are actually going to see what is the nature of that particular JavaScript, what is the nature of that particular embedded file we are talking about. So we can say that once we have analyzed a file using PDF ID, the next thing that we can do is we can parse the entire PDF document using this tool, PDF parser. So PDF ID will tell me that it is malicious, and PDF parser will tell me how is it malicious, what is the strength of that malicious file, what is the nature of that malicious file. So let us see what is the usage of this PDF parser tool. Again, it's very simple, PDF dash parser space dash h. So as we all know, hyphen h or dash h will tell me the various commands or various options that are possible with this particular tool. So let's directly go to the example part. Over here, as you can see, the example is nothing but the same file lminfo.pdf which we saw earlier, and once the PDF parser is run on it, it will tell me what are the various objects present in it. For example, the various font, the font size, the font descriptor, how many pages are there, and what are the various sort of objects present in that particular PDF file. So without wasting much time, let's analyze our malicious PDF document and see whether it consists of any embedded file as it claimed to be or not. So for that, as you can see, we are expecting an embedded file inside this malicious file. So for that, what we can do is, you simply need to type this command PDF parser and the path of the file. So what I can do is, I can simply change the command, previous command, like this, PDF parser. And let's check what it shows as an output. So as you can see, it has given me some sort of an output. Let's see how it looks like. Let me scroll up. Yeah, from here the particular operation has begun. This program has not been tested with this version. Okay, fine, no issues. So let's see how it looks like. The very first thing it found out is an object. As we can see, we are having 9 objects in this particular malicious file. So it will scan each and every object, object number this, object number that, and so on, object 1, object 2, object 3, till all the objects, that is object number 9. So all the objects are analyzed, and somewhere you will be able to see that there is some sort of an embedded file. As you can see, the very first object is referencing to a particular path, and you will see that it is nothing but it is pointing to an embedded file eicardropper.doc, and that is somewhere present in page number 3. So basically we are referring to an object present on the third page of this document file. Although the PDF document which we had downloaded, as you can see, it only consists of a single page, but it is referring to a particular document file whose third page might be having an object which this particular PDF file is referring to, and that is nothing but our open action. So whenever we click somewhere inside this PDF document, we might get automatically redirected to this document file. So it is very simple, it is very easy to find out whether our PDF file is malicious or not. This particular malicious file is intentionally kept malicious, and all the instructions are given over here. As you can see that this particular PDF file consists of a doc file with so and so dropper created by DDS Stevens. So this is intentionally kept malicious, but if you come across any PDF document which you might not know whether it is malicious or not, then in such situations, in such circumstances, you can make use of this tool PDF ID along with PDF parser to check to see whether your particular file is malicious or not. As you can see, it is making use of these many font families, and this is the base font. You will also be able to analyze the font family used, the font type, the font size, etc., and everywhere you can see it is consisting of a particular embedded file eicardropper.doc. So the name of that file will be shown, what is the nature of that file, font family, how is it embedded, each and everything will be shown. As you can see, the action is nothing but it is encoded with a JavaScript. As we saw earlier, that this particular PDF file consists of JavaScripts, one JavaScript. So that is nothing but this JavaScript will open up whenever that particular PDF document will be opened, and your dropper file will automatically be downloaded, or it will automatically be redirected to. So this is how malicious a particular PDF document can be. So just imagine, instead of that simple looking document file, you can even run a JavaScript which can automatically launch a particular malicious file. It could be a virus, it could be a remote access trojan, it could be anything malicious. So you can just imagine how easy, how simply you can make use of a non-suspicious looking PDF file and make the person, make the victim believe that this is nothing but a simple PDF file, but the truth is it is actually malicious, and it may redirect you to a malicious website, or it may automatically download a malware on your computer without even your knowledge. So that is how we can analyze PDF documents, and it is very important for us to analyze the PDF documents, because nowadays internet, as we all know, is the most insecure medium of communication. So if you download something on the internet, it is better off to analyze those documents using this particular tool PDF ID, and then if needed PDF parser. So thanks a lot for watching this video. In the next section, we are going to focus on how to analyze image files to check the metadata information present inside them. So stay tuned.